This cast is brought to you by the letter R. And this wrench. To begin, I'm scrapping some aluminum into ingots. This way there will be a lot less dross, and the aluminum will be more consistent from batch to batch. This is the Corian match plate I machined in part 1. A match plate consists of the top and bottom of a part, as well as the runners combined into a single plate. When this plate is removed, the sand faces that were touching the plate come together to form the parting line of the part. In this case, my own custom dominoes. This is a special snap flask that I made in part 1. It is intended to be used to create multiple molds of this match plate using this flask. I didn't use it this way on this cast. It does make the shakeout easier though. Here I am applying some talc. Corian doesn't need much, as it is already a pretty slippery surface. The black stripe on the flask is there to help me mate the flask correctly. These are vent holes to help the aluminum fill the dominoes and allow for an easy escape for trapped gases. I will do this cast using just propane. Later, I'll show me switching to diesel for scrapping aluminum while the dominoes cool. When I'm using propane, I feel like the furnace is working for me. When I use diesel, I feel like I'm working for the furnace, as consecutive melts go much faster. You'll see what I mean. It was below freezing when I was doing this cast. Here I'm putting some heat into the sand right before I pour. to help the aluminum flow into the mold. The first cast was only half of the dominoes, so now I'll need to switch out the plate on the match plate and ram up another mold. It looks exactly the same as the other mold, so I'll spare you the ram up. This is 00 through 22. This is 23 through 66. Now I'll cut off the sprues and runners. In part 3, I'll clean these up, polish them, and make a box.